still stuck juggling between different apps just to get one shot done?
What if you could do it all in one place? Faster, smarter, and with the help of 15 AI features built right into your workflow?
In this video, we're diving into how D5 is redefining 3D workflows. No more app switching, no more wasted time, just pure creativity, powered by AI. With AI Atmosphere Match, it's super easy to create a mood based on an image or one of the sample scenes. You just pick the view you want, hit Snap Current View to lock in the camera from your viewport, and then either choose an atmosphere from D5's presets or upload your own example. I went with something a bit more mysterious. Misty, darker colors, a more toned down vibe. Once that's set, you just click Generate and wait. For me, it took about 20 seconds to get the result. You can tweak the strength slider or head over to the environment and effects panels to fine-tune things manually. But seriously, just like that, the whole scene feels completely different. It did a great job matching the mood from my reference image. For fun, I tried a totally different sample, something warm and sunny, with orange and yellow-green tones. And again, it nailed the style. Totally different look, but still really solid results. This tool is such a time saver, especially when it comes to post-production and lighting setups. Plus, it's great for quickly showing clients a few different style options. I'm a big fan of this feature. This next feature is super cool. You can actually generate 3D models just by typing in a prompt. Check out some of the examples here that were made using this tool. Or better yet, try it out yourself. Just type what you want. I am going with something simple like deer, but you can get way more specific if you want. You can even tell it what not to include in your model. Then pick a style. I am going with realistic because that just makes sense for this one. Hit the generate button and that's it. Each model generation uses one credit. Alright, here we go. We've got four models to pick from. I'll go with this one. This is a low poly version of the model though. Now I'll hit refine to make it higher quality and add textures. Once that's done, we can just drag and drop it into the scene. I probably wouldn't use these super close to the camera, but they're great for the mid-ground or background. Think about how long it would take to find a decent model online. This saves so much time. And the best part, you can tailor your prompt to get exactly what you need. Definitely worth trying out. If you want to repeat the result, you can always copy the seed and use it one more time. Let's say a client sends over a texture sample. A lot of the time, it's not the best quality and has visible seams.
If we're lucky, we can find a similar one online. But that's not always easy. That's where D5 comes in handy.
When you upload the texture as a base color map, you get access to two AI-powered tools. The first one is Ultra HD Texture. It kicks in super resolution automatically, boosting the texture size by 4 times and showing it directly on the model. It can upscale the texture all the way to 4K, cleaning up any noise or low-res issues while keeping the sharp details intact. The second option is Make Seamless, which will remove seams between base color map textures for a consistent and natural effect. This option supports removing seams either vertically or horizontally to achieve the desired effect. Let me adjust the scene so you can see it more clearly. Here is a different example from the D5 website where you can see how it works. This is another super useful feature for working with materials. Say you only have a sample texture from the client. Usually, that's just the base color map. But to make high-quality materials, we need more than that. With this tool, we can automatically generate normal roughness and height maps from the base color. You can tweak the results if needed, but honestly, it does a pretty solid job right out of the box. Really handy. In D5 at 2.11, there's a cool new feature called AI Material Snap. You just drop in your own reference image, even up to 6K, and it uses AI to generate ready-to-use PBR textures instantly. You can decide if you want displacement or not. In this case, I'm going for a smooth material, so I'll skip it. You can also choose to sample the whole image or just a specific part of it. The system analyzes things like color, pattern, and surface details to create high-quality, tileable materials with just one click. It works pretty well. Not perfect, but the results are really close. And knowing the D5 team, I bet this feature will keep improving quickly. You can still tweak the material if you want, but honestly, the default result is already quite decent. This feature isn't a big deal, but it might still come in handy. When you bring a model into the scene, you can find it in the resource list on the left, right-click it and choose AI Material Match. It'll automatically apply a fitting D5 material template based on common material names and map types. It works fast with almost no weight, and the accuracy is pretty solid. This feature is just awesome. It's part of D5 2.11 and seriously feels like magic. To use it, you just need to turn on the AI agent. There are three scatter types you can pick from. I'm going with the seasonal flower bed. It gives you a default prompt, but you can tweak it however you like. You can type in stuff like the location, color palette, conditions and the season for the planting it's gonna create. First, it shows you a list of plants it'll use. If you're cool with that, hit auto scatter. Then just pick the surface where you want it to go. And that's it. You're done. The result looks super natural and matches the prompt really well. I honestly can't believe how good it is. Think about how much time this saves, especially if you don't need specific plant species. And if you do want to make changes, no problem, you can tweak it anytime. It works just like a regular scatter. This feature is also part of AI Agent, and it's directly related to the previous one. Not only can you create a scatter, but you can also get a complete plant list from your scene with name, size, classification, and quantity. It supports exporting a detailed plant list, including information on habit, color scheme, and season for AI-generated floral landscape. D5 Bot, it's your new friend. It serves as your go-to AI assistant that provides prompt answers to software usage questions and offers intelligent solutions, making technical support more convenient and streamlined. It is generally recommended to describe problems in detail via text. All right, let's jump into the post-production AI workflow. Once you've rendered your image in D5, you'll have access to some pretty awesome AI tools. AI Enhancer can boost different parts of your render, like lighting, materials, people, cars, and plants. You can either tweak specific areas or apply changes to the whole image. Here are the results. We can compare before and after. You can see more details in the areas we selected. Tiles, grass, and trees look better. As I said before, we can also enhance the whole image simply by clicking the AI Enhancer button. There are two sliders, Enhancement Weight and Texture Strength, that let you control how strong the effect is.
The rendering style isn't just for looks. It helps you get your vision across clearly and in a way that grabs attention.
But doing all that manually? Yeah, it can take time. That's where D5 Render's AI Style Transfer comes in. It makes things super easy. No need for tons of post-production. You can pick from the built-in presets or even upload your own reference image. And honestly, the results are impressive. It transforms your image in just seconds. No need to re-render or mess around with environment and effect settings. It's awesome. I can quickly try out different styles, use them as references for the client, and then build my scene based on that. This is another awesome feature. We can inpaint things like the sky, water, vegetation, or even characters into our render after it's done. For example, let's pick water. I went with a calm ocean. I just selected the ocean area in the render and hit inpainting. The result? Honestly, it's amazing. Let me show you a few more. Here I swapped out the sky. It's not perfect since the lighting doesn't quite match, but if we picked something closer to the original, it could totally work. Here's a character tweak. It's a small change, but she definitely looks better. I do wish the hair got a bit more attention though. And check this out, some flowers I added in. I'm really impressed with how well the masking works. I can totally see myself using this tool in my own projects. With the effects, we can add some extra post-production touches after the render is done. Things like sharpening, denoising, and transparency are available. But what really caught my eye was motion blur. You can apply it to the whole image, but it makes more sense to use it on a moving object. In my case, that's a guy on a bike. I can tweak the angle and weight to control how strong the effect is. And honestly, it works really well.
And a little bonus info at the end. The D5 team told me that there is going to be an AI-powered rendering plugin for SketchUp.
It's meant for the early design stage, perfect for quick concepts and lightweight renders, and it'll fit right into the D5 real-time workflow.
With all these AI tools, we can now help ourselves out with pretty much every stage of a project, from the initial concept, through production, like lighting, materials, styles and moods, all the way to post-production. It really speeds up things up and make whole workflow way more efficient. I'm a big fan of D5's AI features. What about you? Let me know in the comments.